baby. Good morning, baby. Hi. Yeah, I slept all right. How about yourself? That's good. I felt you moving last night. I don't know if you had a dream or a nightmare or if you were thinking about anything, but you were doing a lot of shifting. But it's okay. I don't know if you remember, but you woke up and you woke me up and you asked me to hold you. And of course I did. And then we went back to sleep. You didn't seem upset, but you definitely didn't seem happy. So, you know. It's okay. It's okay. I promise it's okay. Remember, we're both off today. Well, yeah, I am called off today for work because I knew that today was the only day in the week that you would be off, so I wanted to spend my day with you. I hope that's okay. That's good. Right now, it looks like it's 9 o'clock, so I was wondering if we can sleep in today. Hey, don't look at me like that. I know you and wanting to be productive and wanting to always get things done, and I respect it. I respect you. I respect the grind. I respect everything. But at the same time, you have to pace yourself. And with pacing yourself, you have to take a break. It's mandatory. Baby, look at me. You're overworking yourself. There's no reason. You only have one off day in the week. In the month, actually. You've gone to work every single day, including doing your schoolwork. It's stressful. It's not even me doing it, and I know it's stressful, because it sounds like it. But you have to remember, not just you. I'm here as well. I'm here to help you, support you emotionally, physically, romantically, however you want me. I'll be there for you. You just have to let me. Okay? Good. So with that being said, we can sleep in, okay? Thank you. Oh, baby, come here. Well, yeah, because when you woke me up and you asked me to hold you, I did, and I felt very comfortable. And it was really nice, but then when I woke up, you were on, I think, your side of the bed, and I was on mine, and we weren't, you know, together, so I didn't want to touch you, because if I did, I probably would have woke you up. So I've been waiting maybe like 2 hours for you to wake up so I can hold you again. I mean, yeah, but if you think about it, you could either sleep and get another 2 hours, or I can poke you, hold you, and you wake up. You don't get those 2 hours, and you're just in my arms. I would rather you get more sleep and be more energized throughout the day than cuddle me. That was very, very hard to say, but I mean it. Because I care about you a lot, and I care about your mental health, your physical health. I care about all of it. You're my baby, my darling, my love. That's like number one priority. Hey, where are you going? But baby, you just said we can sleep in. Do you promise to come back to bed? Pinky promise. You know how seriously I treat pinky promises, right? Meaning, if you break it, we're gonna have an issue. I'm just joking, alright? Calm down. I love you so much. Anyways, go do your thing. I'll be here, or not, maybe. I don't know. Well, honestly, depends on how long you take. You can go in the bathroom and shower, brush your teeth, do all these things, and take literally forever. So, if you leave the bathroom and you look at the bed and I'm not there, I am most likely in the kitchen eating something. Because it is the morning and I need breakfast to survive. Well, I don't really need it, but it's a lot easier for me to go throughout my day if I have breakfast. Because if you don't eat in the morning, you won't have enough energy in your body to carry out throughout the day. It's a saying, and at first I didn't really believe it, but after going a couple days without eating breakfast, I can confidently say breakfast is the most important meal of the day. It doesn't matter if you eat breakfast and you don't eat lunch or dinner. As long as you had a breakfast, it literally sets the mood for the entire day. Which is, it's nice, it honestly is, but some meals are a lot less energy filled than others. Like, for example, a lot of people like waffles or pancakes and eggs and sausage and bacon. I love bacon. But then there's other people that like cereal or oatmeal or something that's very quick and easy to make. It comes down to the person, and it, you know, helps different people feel different ways. I am so sorry. I honestly don't know how I was able to yap in your ear about breakfast for 2 minutes. That is insane. Anyways, go do your morning stuff and I'll be here, okay? Okay. Love you. Look at you all gorgeous and everything. Anyways, you took forever. Hey, I'm not gonna sugarcoat anything. You are my baby, and you are my darling, but you took almost an hour, and within that hour, I ate something, and I had even more time to cook you something to eat. So, with that being said, if you look to your right on the dresser, you will see a tray with a very, very well-made breakfast, orange juice, your favorite bacon, and a muffin. Because for some reason, you are obsessed with muffins. You're just like me. And it's taking everything from me to not take that off your tray and eat it right now. But I love you, so I'll leave you be. Yeah, all of that's for you. What do you mean, what about me? I told you I ate. Oh, you know, I had a very well-seasoned and garnished, sautéed, pan-seared, cooked-to-perfection bowl of cereal. I promise you, it's the best thing in the world. Listen. I love cereal. If I can have a bowl of cereal for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, I would. But that would be a waste, so I don't. You're so adorable whenever you smile. Anyways, eat up, because we have a lot planned for today. Well, the plan is you eat your food, you get full, you get tired, and we sleep until the afternoon. Well, it's like 10 right now, so sleeping in does require sleeping, you know? So we're gonna sleep, and when we wake up, we can probably go to the mall, but I'm still thinking about it. You know what? Let's worry about that when we wake up, okay? Enjoy your food, and whenever you're done, just leave it there and I'll come back, okay? Oh, no, baby, I'm not going anywhere. Last night I was doing a load of laundry, and I accidentally left the load in the dryer, so I have to go get it. I'll be right back, baby, okay? Don't worry. Baby, I told you, when you finished your food, leave the tray there and I'll go get it. Why did you come to the kitchen? You're so stubborn. You're lucky you don't get sick. Because if you got sick, then I could finally take care of you. You don't let me at all. Whenever I try to offer my help or assistance, yeah, you do let me help, and yeah, I do assist you, but there's never a time where I'm like completely helping you and you can't do anything. I like to spoil you, and you don't let me. No, that's not what I'm trying to say. I know you're independent, and I know you could do everything yourself, but every once in a while, I want to do everything for you. I want you to kick back, relax with your feet up, sipping a nice juice, doing absolutely nothing, and letting me do everything. Because you're my baby. You're a hard worker, and you never give up. The least I can do for you is show you just how much I love you. Okay? So, starting now, let me love you, okay? Please. Thank you. My baby. Anyways, you finished your food. I'm assuming you're full. Alright, good. I'll clean your plate whenever we do wake up, but as of right now, we're going to bed, okay? Come here, my love. Good night, baby. Or good morning, I guess. Sleep well.